Hello dear students, now this is another video for you. In this video we will talk about the Golgi apparatus. This Golgi apparatus is also called as Golgi complex, which is again one of the important organelle of the cell. So this Golgi apparatus diagram is shown here. So which parts are found in the Golgi apparatus? Incoming transport vesicles are found. Lumen of the Golgi complex is there, newly forming vesicles, then the two faces, the cis face and trans face is also seen here, then secretory vesicles are seen. So about all these components we will discuss today. This Golgi complex is a stack of membranous flattened sacs and vesicles which are interconnected by tubules. So in this Golgi complex basically there are number of stacks of membranous sac like structures are found, and these are interconnected by tubules. Golgi complex size and shape vary in different cells. So this shape and size varies cell to cell. It is made up of stack of cisternae and a peripheral network of vacuoles, vesicles and tubules. Now in the previous video we have talked about endoplasmic reticulum. So in that case also, in endoplasmic reticulum also, the components which are present there are cisternae, then vesicles and tubules. So in the same way, this Golgi complex is also possess the same type of cisternae, then vacuoles, vesicles and tubules. Now the first part, first component of Golgi apparatus is cisternae. These are elongated, flattened sac-like structures which are filled with fluid, and they are present one upon the other, and they are forming a stack. The number of these cisternae, the stack, varies from 2 to 8, and sometimes it may be 25 to 30. Some cisternae are fenestrated. Fenestrated means they are having holes. The Golgi complex has two sides, namely face, forming face and maturing face. The convex surface is forming cis face, and concave surface is forming mature face or trans face. So trans face is facing towards plasma membrane. In the diagram you can see the trans face and the cis face. So exactly the this trans face is facing towards plasma membrane, and the cis face is towards the nucleus. Okay, so the other component is vacuole. Second is vacuoles. These are large, spacious, round sacs found at the edge of cisternae. At the edges of the cisternae, these vacuoles are found. So these are rounded structures, round sac-like structures, which are found at the edges of the cisternae. These are formed by the expansion of the cisternae, and in which the two membranes are widely separated. The third one is vesicles. These are small droplet-like structures, about 40 angstroms in diameter. These vesicles are closely associated with the periphery of the cisternae. So these are found, very close association is found with the periphery of the cisternae and the vesicles. The next part is tubule. Next component of the Golgi apparatus is tubules. These are from the trans face of cisternae. Many small tubules arise and interconnect the cisternae, the vacuoles and vesicles. They transport substances between them. These are 300 to 450 angstrom in diameter. So diameter is of this tubules is much more, that is 300 to 450, and these all are the components of Golgi apparatus, that is tubules, vesicles and the cisternae. Now let's move to the functions of Golgi complex. In this function of the Golgi complex, the very important function is formation of formation of the acrosome. The acrosome of sperm is developed from Golgi apparatus during spermatogenesis. So the acrosome, which is a part of the sperm, is developed with the help of this Golgi apparatus during spermatogenesis process. Second function of Golgi apparatus is the formation of plasma membrane. So it is involved in the formation of plasma membrane. Next function is formation of primary lysosomes. It helps in the formation of primary lysosomes. Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus carries out the trafficking function in the transport of biosynthetic products. Then it also helps in the secretion of mucus, then oil, sweat, tear, enzymes and hormones, again antibodies, then neurotransmitters, milk and various glands. So from various glands of our body the Golgi apparatus plays a very important role in the secretion of different substances or hormones or tear or all these materials. Then the next function is the Golgi apparatus also have the ability of concentrating and storing the secretory products until they are demanded. So they store the secretory substances which are secreted by different glands or organs of the body, and whenever they are needed, they are then further released into the organ. So this is also one of the important function, that is storage of secretory substances. Then it also helps in the process of metabolism of the sulfate. So this is the end of this video. So if you understand, if you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you.